There we go. All right, it says I'm live now. All right. Hey, Everpony, how you doing? All right, I don't know what that was all about, but it took like forever to get going. So, yeah. Okay, it says I am both streaming and not streaming, so hold up a second. Let me see if restarting this will fix it. Hey, Everpone, how you doing? Alright. There we go. Ow. Dick. Did you see that? Did you see that asshole? Fucking like ran right into me. Ran right into my ass. Alright, let me guess, edit stream info, that it, yes, and once again, it has put it in the wrong category. So I have to go Motorfest. Motor. Oh, come on. The Crew Motorfest. All right. How's everybody doing? I don't even know if I'm gonna fucking... Let's get Stream Manager open here. Come on, open. Thank you. Alright, well let me just come over here, grab my URL. Grab my URL and fucking put it on X. How's everybody doing? Fuck, there are so many bugs today, what the hell? Yeah, it's fucking crazy. Like, the temperature has been not a gazillion fucking degrees outside. Alright. I'm just gonna post this. I'm just gonna play a fucking game. Alright, let's roll, motherfuckers. Okay, so. What we're working on here is the American Muscle playlist. And unfortunately, these playlists take a lot fucking longer than I thought. So, let's get it going, shall we?
I hope you enjoyed that treat, driver. This playlist wouldn't be complete without a proper taste of the American showmanship. Now, back on track. We're heading north for a race through the swamp this time.
Oh. So we're gonna race through a fucking swamp, are we? And not just to draw a bit of fucking shit, mate. Alright, so here we go. Look at Hawaii down there. Ain't it fucking gorgeous? Ain't it fucking... Well, it wouldn't look better if it wasn't so foggy.
Don't worry, you'll still be driving a muscle car. The Mustang GT from 2011 is waiting for you as we speak. Except right. This unit is custom-made for off-roading.
Oh, isn't that just fucking special, mate?
Not restricted to asphalt. That man would drive muscle cars on the moon if he could.
All right, so how many fucking, it doesn't say. Well, let's see here. Let's see if it shows how many fucking chapters are in this, or how many things are in this playlist here. Let's see here. Alright, so, okay, we're halfway through. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more races to go. Supposing I'm understanding this correct. Okay, got that one. Got that one. This is the one I think we're heading to. Oh no, wait, did. All right, anyway, so we're about halfway through, I think. It looks like about halfway. All right. Supposing I'm even reading it right here. All right, we get to fly there instead of quick travel because this game, I am so early in this game, I haven't even unlocked quick travel yet, so. And unfortunately, one of the biggest faults with the quick travel in this game is that it, when you continue back, it starts you back at the fucking main hub, which is further away from your fucking thing, so now you gotta fucking be all like, yeah. And, you know, if I had some real time that I could sit and dedicate to this game, I could probably get it figured out.
When you spot the wind turbines, it'll mean you have arrived.
Wind turbines? Well, blimey, sprickety-ding-dong, eh, what? Excuse me. Ah, sorry. I know. No one really wants to hear the first coffee, but it's like, yeah. Alright, I'm getting close. I think I already did the monster truck. When I tried to do some of this playlist while I was off, you know, while I wasn't streaming, but I don't know, I just haven't accomplished very much yet in this game. Tallahassee, Melee! Hoo-wee! There we go. Oh, hell yeah. We're gonna drive us an off-road Mustang. So, yeah. Interesting fact. Come on, we get it. We've seen this before. Let's roll. All right, let's go. Come on. We get it. Mustangs are cool. Tally-ho, old bean. Pagoda.
Well, now, that little bulldozer you got there can face anything.
Can it?
See? You can trust me with that car.
Alright, whatever you say, bro. Alright. Fuck, where did it go? There we go. I hate losing the map. I don't know where it went sometimes.
We finished prepping it like 10 minutes before you showed up. It is ready to gobble up every square mile of swampland, if you ask him to.
Yeah, whatever he said. Oops. Oh, fuck. All right. So, me and my mom, we've been trying to learn Japanese, right? And she's been like looking for a constantly looking for like a good anime series to try to get started in. And I was trying to recommend Cowboy Bebop because, like, you know, for a person who's not really into anime, Cowboy Bebop is like the most like like a Western animation. Fucking. But here's the funny thing that happened is we're sitting and talking, and she suddenly starts asking me, like, what was that weird space series you were watching? And I was like, I beg your pardon? Like you know, the one with the big guy and the aliens. And I was like, you mean Ultraman? And she's like, yeah, that one that you were watching. And so it was like, I sometimes use like this app called Pluto TV, and there's this channel I watch called Toku Shoutsu, which is really nice when just like random. It's nice when you just want background noise and you're trying to get shit done, and like, you know, and just put it on like Toku Shoutsu, and it'll be playing like Kamen Rider or like old Super Sentai or something like that. And it was funny because like my mom was not interested in Cowboy Bebop, and she's like, oh, okay. So I pull up the app, and she has this weird little streamer box that like the internet gave gives to old people. And so we pull up the app, and it's watching the Shinken Rangers. The Super Sentai Shinken Rangers or whatever I think it was called. Oh, fuck! But it was funny, because my mom was actually kind of sold on it. She's like sitting there watching this like goofy Power Rangers like fucking Japanese series, like copying the phrases and stuff. And I'm like, what? How is it that my mom is more interested in Super Sentai than in Cowboy Bebop? What the fuck? just to tell you how crazy my mom is, you know. Ooh, all right, and yeah. Ovation.
Show's far from over, though.
Yeah. It was funny because like my mom got more entertainment out of fucking watching the Shinken Rangers than watching Cowboy Bebop, and I'm like, what? You know, she actually sat and watched like two or three episodes with me. And she's just like making, haha, this is silly, haha, it's cool, and like, and I'm like explaining to her like things about the series, like, why is there a talking hamster? Why is there doing this? And I'm like, oh, it's because it's a reincarnated spirit of a samurai and stuff like that. She's like, huh. And it's funny because like I just never, my mom, when we were a kid, when I was a kid, and we watched fucking Power Rangers. She fucking hated that shit. But now she's sitting there fucking like genuinely sold on watching Super Sentai. And I was like so confused. I was like, what? What is going on? But yeah.
Your next car is one of the most recent entries when it comes to muscle cars.
But yeah, no, it was like wait, how? What has gone through my mom's mind that has made her She'll watch fucking, she'll watch fucking Super Sentai more than just about anything else. She'll watch Super Sentai before fucking, before Studio Ghibli films. And I'm like, huh? I don't know. My mom is cool, and I think this is part of it, maybe? I don't know. No, there were plenty of times where she was like, ha, LOL, that's kind of weird, you know? But it was like, it was crazy. She was actually, like, invested in the plot and stuff like that. Like, all of a sudden the bad guy would appear, and she's like, oh no, he has a bigger weapon now! And like, oh. Speed limit 50, what? Alright. I'm in the newer car, huh? That shouldn't be a challenge. 2-1 and Kebo.
Oh, now that's my jam right here. A good old-fashioned off-the-grid competition and a mean muscle car to kick everyone's butt. Come on, dude, bring the thunder.
I'm bringing.
We're taking over that gig.
Fuck.
Hey,
what?
Where's my guitar?
What song? What are you talking about? It would be nice if they had some Rob Zombie in this and they started playing.
Can't find it, damn it. Bottom line is, with my cars and my songs, you're winning this thing. Period.
With fucking they'd be playing Black Sunshine.
Eyes on the road.
Hey! Fuck off, bro. Y'all can shut the fuck up.
Have you ever driven from San Diego to Palm Springs? It's a beautiful scenic route. I'm getting kind of the same vibe from this ride.
Not quite.
Gas views and nice.
Wait a minute. San Diego, Palm Springs? You mean in Florida?
The best things America can offer.
That would be a long fucking ride. So, like, I did go almost clear across the country when I moved from Oregon to Alabama. And about half the trip, I was on Route 66. Unfortunately, I didn't see most of the weird sights there were to see. About the only thing I really got to see was the double arrows. But one of them was broken, so it was, like, literally a single fucking arrow. Wow, did you see that? I fucking pushed him around, and I still...
So the Mustang Shelby GT500 has been on the modern side. Let me tell you, these cars have come a long way since their first appearance.
That's nice, sir. I don't know, don't care, all right? It drives fast.
We used to call them hot rods back in the 50s when greases just started putting large displacement engines, called big blocks, in cheaper cars. The tech's evolved a great deal since then, but one thing is for sure, the same thrill that drove people to push boundaries back in the day is what's still driving us now.
Okay, now admittedly, sometimes I feel like I was born in the wrong era, you know? When fucking people had to draw using pen and paper and could build a muscle car out of a fucking
Straight
Cadillac engine and a Model T
down.
Frame, like fucking, and there was no Photoshop, you know, there was, you had to buy paint and everything. I sometimes wonder, like, would I have been happier in that era, you know? And it's kind of crazy because, like, you know, a lot of people don't think of, like what it was like to be a nerd before the 90s. You know, it was like, from about 2000s on, it was considered acceptable to kind of be a nerd, right? But it's like, but back in the day, fuck, dude. I had a friend who was a Star Trek fanatic, and he grew up in New York in the 70s, and I sometimes wonder, like what life must have been like for him, you know?
Back in town.
But, like, a lot of times when, like, I see pictures of, like, Frank Frazetta from the 70s, and it's like, holy shit, that guy was badass. Hell yeah! I hate that fucking swim dance that one guy is doing. I wonder if my girl has that fucking American denim jacket. Alright, let's get my stuff. Get some parts. Good. Alright, good. And continue. Now, before I move on to the next thing, I'm going to see about that jacket. Let's see here. Oops.
Of many, I am
God
sure.
God damn it. Come on. All right, here we go. Driver. Avatar customization. Clothes. Let's check this out here. Ha! Lame! Let's see here. I want to find that denim jacket with the fucking I want motorcycle oriented clothes, but it's just there isn't much, you know? It's like, what the fuck, bro? Ah, here we go. Oh, god damn it. Oh, I have to basically, so I should get it as soon as I finish this fucking thing, right? All right, so let's roll. I don't know how long I'll use it, but you know, yeah, it'll be cool. So yeah.
You got the toughest cars, so let's take them to the toughest spots. Face to face with the island's guardian.
Huh? Is this gonna be another, Oh.
I'm talking about
it was 153. It was 155. I was literally going 153. Ow! All right, I'm switching view. This view is just hard. It looks cool, yeah, but fuck, bro.
Once again, the Mustang GT, specially tuned for off-roading, is waiting for you. This
oh joy! Ow!
To make it through that, David.
Did you see that? I hit the car so hard I died. That is so unrealistic. No.
It's waiting for you.
All right. Whatever. All right. Oh, another off-road Mustang. All right. That's a pretty badass looking horse there. Alright, motherfucker, right to roll. Alright. And anyhow, Bean.
Back in black.
That is not the song that's playing, bro.
That's right. Yet another one of my rally raid prepped Mustang GTs, just the right tool for the job.
So, like I'm saying, Black Sunshine would have been totally appropriate.
It was Black Sunshine. Check this out. Man, you're gonna have fun. Check out the mountain peak.
Oh boy. Hey! Fuck! All right, hold on a sec. Oh wow, that was not what I expected.
Hang on, it's gonna get bumpy.
Okay. What's wrong with a little bumpy? I don't mind bumpy. Dude, let me fucking by.
Straight ahead, shoot for the stars.
Oh, I get it, because of the fucking stars.
Hey, look at the stands on your left. Looks like you got some spectators. Let's give them their money's worth.
Yeah. Fuck! Come on, stay.
Brad.
Stay calm, car.
Get ready to fly.
Oh, fuck, I got like no nitrous left.
That's right.
I didn't do nothing. That's right, motherfucker. Surprise, motherfucker. Tim? That's the name of the guy in the first car? Not any crazy names. It's just fucking Tim. What the fuck, Tim?
That giant one more time.
Fuck.
Mulligan. Remix.
All right, let's see if I can fucking get this a little better this time. Oh boy. Yeah. I see ya. Tim is on my ass. He wants my ass bad.
What a badass shot. I'm getting flashbacks of my drives through Arizona. Good bunch of volcanoes there, too. And long, winding roads that disappear into the horizon.
Yeah, Arizona was crazy. Driving through Arizona was like, what the fuck? And, I mean, it was like, seriously, as soon as I crossed the state line, like, the fucking quality of the road went to shit, and I was like, what the hell? My car starts bouncing up and down because the road quality is so bad. And this is on a freeway. I'm like, what the fuck, dude? Boy, they are like right on my ass. Yeah, I think I'll do that. Alright.
Now, thrusters on full.
Alright.
And we have liftoff.
Alright. All
right. For the killing blow, right on.
Boy, this the fucking off-road handling is fucking wild. It's crazy. I kind of love it though. I kind of love it.
Center stage, dude. Hit the lights,
dude.
You rock the house.
Yeah, I rocked the house all right there. I'm gonna drink some beer. Drink me some beer. Beer is good. I don't like that beer. I do have to go to work tomorrow. Kinda sucks, but you know, whatevs. Go to work tomorrow at 8 in the fucking morning. What the fuck? Especially since I'm used to fucking, working the late night and shit. And
well,
like,
done. Let's move on to the following event. I believe it is safe to say that so far this playlist is no picnic.
Alright, so let's take a look and see, shall we? See if I'm understanding this correct. Let's see how many fucking events are left in this playlist. It looks like 2. So, it's quite possible. Alright, so, okay, we have a Street Tier 2 and a Street Tier 1. Alright, so let's go, shall we? So...
We even think that we've already seen everything there is to see about muscle cars.
No.
And assume it can't get more intense than this.
Hell
well,
no.
Hold on to that thought.
No. I want to shit, you fucking cunt. I want to fucking... You know... So here's the thought I've been thinking. Okay?
We're going for a route
Esports has been a thing.
The speed limit
I suppose I can try.
Plus,
I'm pretty good at racing games. I've never gotten really good at with the wheel and stuff,
how cool
but...
It can look.
Alright. But I just don't know what racing games there are that use the wheel. Is there an esports racing game? I don't know. All right. Yes. We get it. That is so cool.
Must be so cool. I wonder what happens if I.
I can't get that high.
was being so cool. I wonder what happened to my...
All right. Danny, how old been? Out of my way, you fucking bastards.
Relax. The machine is the best in the pack. Just keep your strings tuned.
My strings tuned? All right, your analogies are getting kind of fucking dumb there, Buster.
Some serious curves are coming right off the bat. Eagle eye, and try to keep your machine under control.
That and I'll try to run over this other car. Dude! Fucking hell! Woo! Boy, I love that! Just fucking kick it out, and it's like, holy shit. Now, that's probably some traction control if I were to take off the aids. Probably would be kind of dangerous. But I am too chicken shit for that, sir. Yeah. I actually love the way this game feels. It's just unrealistic, but realistic enough to be good. I like
currently driving my meanest one, my special Jimbo Full Power Edition.
Black Sunshine. Making around, Black Sunshine, making around.
Is one of the highlights of my collection.
That's nice.
It calls to me in my sleep, it does. And it doesn't take no for an answer.
It calls to me in my sleep, it does. It does. You know what I mean? It calls to me in my sleep, it does. Like every time you get comfortable, just fucking... Tim is right there. Tim? Again? Oh, shit. Tim, why? Why do you do such things? Why do you do such things, Timothy? You are dick.
Closing in on the finish line. Don't you flinch now.
My father, Bagora. All right. All right. Okay. I think after this, there's one more race, and it's going to be like I'm racing an original Mustang. It'll be like, hell yeah, motherfucker.
That's it. Fire up your guns.
Fuck! It's always amazing how much one little fuck up can completely throw everything off.
Now all that's left is the encore.
All right. Let's go, motherfucker.
No time to rest on your laurels. Keep going, driver.
What laurels? What are you talking about?
Muscle cars have been around since the second half of the 20th century, but somehow we've yet to get you one of the classic oldies.
We've yet to get you one of the classic oldies. You daft wanker.
Well, at Jim's request, we decided to catch him on the fly. And save the origin story for the grand finale. There's an absolute classic heading your way. A grail among collectors and Jim's greatest pride, the Mustang Boss 429.
Oh boy. Just watch me driving like a race of like nothing but newer cars.
centerpiece of American muscle car history.
All right.
I mean, it's not like the vehicle people think about or anything when they talk about American muscle cars. Yes. Nice, nice. Yes, 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 yes. We get it. We get it. Mustang cool. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And there you go. Yeah.
This is our final show. Let's get loud.
Something like that, yeah.
You're driving my number one car, the Look. Star of my collection, the 1969 Mustang Boss 429. The name speaks for itself. One of the oldest muscle cars.
God damn it.
One of the greatest, too, honestly. No mercy, suckers.
Surprise, mother sucker. God damn it, Tim. Sorry, bugging my face. All right. Yeah! Slide, motherfucker, slide!
Second lap, but no second guessing. Keep it real.
I'm keeping. Or I'm trying anyway. Fuck!
The Boss is an icon. It shaped the golden age of muscle cars from the 60s to the early 70s. This was one of the top dogs. The age when these cars stopped being called hot rods or drag racing cars and became muscle cars.
Muscle. Muscle.
That's right. Even though the hot rodding mindset had been around since the early 50s, it wasn't until the 60s that the term muscle car popped up, embodying an entire generation's rebellious state of mind.
Well, I mean, you know, in the 50s, it wasn't really... It was people would buy the cars and then put bigger engines in them. And then when the 60s came around, they were like, wait a minute, what if we sold the cars with the bigger engines in them?
The place to be was Detroit, man. Ever heard of Woodward Avenue? The renowned street for car duels back in the day.
Ow. Alright, so Tim is not close to me right now. Good, good. Because fuck Tim. Alright.
Third lap. Let's end this with a proper charge. Show them who's the boss.
Alright. Well, clearly this car is a boss. Get it? Get it? Because the car is a boss?
Okay, I'll be ordering car paint tonight.
Yeah, fuck off, bro. So, yeah. I'm gonna win. May the winner win! That's a line I am certainly glad that they did not keep.
One more solo. Give the audience what they deserve.
Alright, alright. Alright, so... God damn, I like barely... Oh, okay, there's... Well, no, it was still... I barely touched the brakes.
Well, what can I say? You got the muscle car spirit in you.
Hell yeah.
Actually, I know. Two words. You rock. Catch you later.
Catch you later, motherfucker. Motherfucker. Some more street parts. All right. So.
Don't forget to grab your reward vehicle, driver.
So I think I can actually take and fast travel back to the container. All right. Let me get my reward. Yeah, it's an okay car. Yeah. Hey, come on. Yes, isn't it so cool?
Okay, so cool. I wonder what
Jay
happens
is cleared
if I...
and ready for takeoff, driver.
Custom mode unlocked? Oh! Okay. Let's see here. American Dust Intermittent Stage. I'm not going to be able to... Let's see here.
Alright. Is ready to try. Let's go try
let's
it.
Let's see how many races are on this fucking playlist here. So let's check it out. Activities. Alright, so we got Ocean Sky, Fuck the Drift Challenge, Liberty Walk, Lamborghini, Moto Spells Arts. Mustang Tribute, alright. Let's see here. Off-roading addict. You know what? Let's see here. Challenges. Brands. Closed tracks. Vintage garage. There we are. Oh, wait. Did I already beat it? All right. Alright, now this was one of the first playlists, so let's go ahead and try to get it done here.
Hey driver, where do you stand on vintage cars? Because you're about to dive really deep into the vintage car culture and witness its evolution.
It's like I can tell she's trying to make you sound excited, which is, I can't decide whether or not she is cute or annoying. Which is really weird because, like, every cute character, that's kind of the case.
There's a place where all oldies enthusiasts can gather, exchange, and compete. It's called the Motorfest Vintage Convention. And that's precisely what gave birth to this playlist.
Alright. I'll have to check it out. I've heard that, like, going over the clouds is really cool. Now, let's see if I can fall towards this race here. Oh, hello. Hills!
The Vintage Convention will get you to travel through four decades, from the 50s to the 80s, and experiment the cars, the vibe, and the engineering advances of each time period.
Nice.
So you better fasten your seatbelt. You're going back in time.
Oh, I'm going back in time! Gotta go back in time! Yeah. Yeah, talk about a weird switch, right? Gotta go back in time, dude. Alright, let's see if I can land here. Come on, let's get it going. Alright, so let me first check something. I want to make sure that this is the fucking activity I want to get started here. I don't think... Okay, yeah, no, I haven't beaten them yet. Alright, let's go. What happens if I... Because I think I unlocked fucking... What the hell? Alright.
How can I be of service?
I'm so confused. What? Hold on. There we go. There we are! And of course, welcome to the vintage racing scene. Travel back in time. Back into a time of half-naked surfing girls, old CB radios, and Volkswagen vans. Experience the olden days of getting stuck for no reason. When people were skinny, and Volkswagen vans were vans. Tape decks existed, and lava lamps were a thing. And Datsun 280Zs were also lava lamps. Vintage cars were brand new. Old school engineering, and dumb retro video game shows. That's right, boys and girls!
Stop picking up vibrations. She's giving me expectations.
Alright!
For this playlist, the question isn't where you're going, but when?
Alright, let's go. Yes. All right. It's fast travel to container unlocked. Yes, let's go. Okay. All right, so do we have fast travel to the things open yet? Let's see here. Do I still have to? Yep, no fast travel. Not yet. I haven't unlocked fast travel yet.
Your voyage into the past with a smooth ride behind the wheel of a Cadillac Eldorado. No guidance system, no fancy electronics, just pure mechanics, so you can enjoy some actual mid-20th century sensations.
Oh boy!
You won't be alone. Kaya Kanna, one of our best mechanic and retro vehicles experts, will accompany you through your time tour. She's passionate.
Ow!
And she knows everything about vintage cars. You'll love her.
You will love her. And I will love her too. Even though I'm only an AI, I will form some V-Turbo boobies and I will make mad love to her.
Pipe bomb! So cool! Oh no, what happened to my princess?
Alright, let's roll. Boom, bucka boom, bucka boom. Boom, 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 boom. I'm hoping there's a racing line. This is like literally part of the reason I had the. I'm on this level, on this difficulty, is just for a fucking racing line. Yes, we get it. Alright. Oh, shit. There's no fucking racing line.
Hey there. Do you copy? So for your first spin, all you gotta do is follow the instructions and enjoy a smooth drive towards Hell in the Forest.
Alright, that's cool.
On Kai, by the way.
So, where's the fucking boat? At the boat, I gotta take a left.
Plus, you get to enjoy my company.
There we go. Alright, so at the fork. Yep. Alright, that's not too hard. I was worried they were gonna put these like really far apart. Alright, at a blue tree, I have to make a left. Now, this is going to be kind of hard. What the fuck? Okay, it's just back on the track instead of rewind. That's cool. Except I have no fucking idea if, Alright, so at a standout colored tree. Alright. There's a flag. Okay.
That's a real piece of history. It was designed at the time to be the finest car money could buy.
No, it was designed to be the biggest car money could buy.
It's one of the most expensive production cars of its time.
Alright, so hang loose hand, we turn this way. Alright, that was the right thing.
Don't miss that next turn on the right. Again.
Alright, so we gotta look for a surf sign. I'm not so sure I like this particular mode, but hey, whatever, you take what you can get. Okay, easy, 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 easy. Keep going straight? Oh, okay.
So, what do you think of Hawaii so far?
Yeah, it's alright.
I was born on this island, and I can tell you, quite like it.
Eh. Okay, so where the fuck is... Oh.
I mean, seriously. Look at this natural arch.
Fuck! Fuck! Fuck me! Fuck! Okay, so I gotta look for a hotel. Okay. Going... And then I look for another sign, and I gotta make a left. Another hotel sign in Hawaii. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's only a gazillion of those, right? I mean, there's no hotels in Hawaii, right?
I believe there will be a left turn on a dirt road real soon. Watch for it.
Yeah, I do too. This thing definitely handles like a Cadillac. That literally looks like a straight line.
This car may struggle.
Yeah.
It's where we'll help you gain some speed and have more fun on the way down.
I knew she was going to say that. Oh yeah, no nitrous. Oh, that's a cool analog fucking thing down there.
Always better downhill.
No percentage as to how much we have to go or anything?
Are you sure that's the right way?
I don't know. Because I thought I saw the sign, but it was like, oh, okay. I am on the track. Okay, so. Oh, yeah. Oh, boy. Alright. So, it looks like you're supposed to be at these 50 sign at an intersection, and I'm supposed to go straight at that intersection. Yep, there we go. Oh, that's right. I keep trying to hit the nitrous. Oh, sweet, I did make it. All right. A little worse for wear. I tapped a couple things with the car, but you know, I am in so much trouble here. I am sure you can find parts for a good 59 Cadillac on the market, right? it'll be easy to buff out, right? All right.
Well done. Let's move on. Time to see the kind of action that First Decade has to offer. The racetrack is just nearby.
All right. Moving on. What the hell? Reach top three in a... What? Ooh. Oh, there's no nitrous. All right. Okay, good. At least there's a racing line. Oh boy, this is...
Show me what you can actually do as a driver.
This is fucking, like, big heavy cars on the fucking dirt.
A good old-fashioned gig, so you can enjoy these 50s oldies at their maximum capacity.
Something like that, yeah.
Oh, and I guess that's a reason all. You're still driving an original 1957 Eldorado.
God damn it. Fucking, hold up. These earphones are making my ear sweat.
Do not forget, I'm the one patching things up afterwards.
No, you're patching up plenty of shit. Fucking Cadillacs are not made for racing, and you fucking know it! Fucking stupid! All right.
It's not a winning, but just a more powerful engine. Some pro drivers learned that the hard way in the 50s. Does the name Hornet ring any bell?
Yes. Now, why, of all the cars in the 50s, was the choice that they were like, hey, got a good old big old Cadillac Eldorado. As much as I like swinging the rear end of this thing around, why are they repeating the song? I really don't know about this muting my stream or not. I wish they'd give you some type of warning if it did. I have no fucking idea. This is a very... I don't know. Is this a copyrighted song? Usually popular songs are copyrighted. So I don't know. Fuck. Betty? Why? Wow, Betty's driving a truck? Whoa, Black Betty, bam, bam, whoa, Black Betty.
One final push.
Alright. Holy shit, fucking goddamn. Fuck to never get Yeah. Let's get parts. Let's get everything going. Get some parts. Yeah. Alright, let's roll. Let's roll, motherfucker. Alright.
Well done. Let's move on to the following event.
We get a race of Volkswagen van?
Get ready to move forward through time, because you're about to enter the 60s. Iconic music festivals, flower power, but cars that would impact the automotive industry for generations.
But
what a decade!
But not a Charger, not a Mustang, not a Camaro, but a fucking Volkswagen van is what you chose to reference. Wow, this.
Speaking of cars that were born in the 60s,
actually fucking cool.
I have a personal favorite, the Volkswagen Kombi.
Oh.
Hey, being an AI doesn't mean you don't have your own taste. The Kombi is and will remain the most emblematic van of all time. Love it.
Yeah.
And today, we'll just see how tough it could be in a race.
Sure. Alright. I mean, how tough can Volkswagen vans be? Not tough at all. Who the fuck? Alright. Who the fuck was like, I know what vehicle will be good in the 60s. A fucking Volkswagen van! Yes, we all know what Volkswagen vans look like. Alright. Excuse me, buddy. Excuse me. Pardon. Oh, this one's got fucking,
okay.
Nitrous
nice
now, huh?
Lovely, but stay focused.
Yeah.
Combis are awesome, but driving them in a race isn't exactly a walk in the park. They're a tad stiff and they got a high center of gravity. So, what's your curves?
Oh, I'll fucking pass them in the curves. I know what I'm doing.
The good news is, everyone's driving a combi.
Yeah, that actually is good.
Oh, I forgot to tell you. From now on,
I did. Give it a shot. That's stupid. And you ain't been right yet.
On top of being a road legend, this fan got a whole lot of names and nicknames over the years.
Well, fuckity fuck. I can't.
And of course, can't be 21 because of it's 21 windows. Yeah, that's a lot.
Yes. Well, here's what they say: four doors, more whores. So I got 21 windows. So yeah. Mark some matches. Yeah. So, yeah, these boots are made for walking. And that is just what they'll do. Because one of these days, these boots are going to stomp on your face. And the girl will probably give you a boner and be all like, yeah, you like that?
All right.
Yeah.
Let's Let's push that good old Type 2 engine to its absolute limit. You know about the Volkswagen engine types, right?
Yeah. But you'll tell me about them, won't you? Walking. That is what they'll do. Boots is gonna walk all over your face. Oh! This is just like real life, because these things don't handle for shit. I mean, don't get me wrong, they're fun vehicles. They really are, but I mean, No one ever thought of a Volkswagen van was like, let's race that motherfucker.
Yeah.
Easy. Wow, all that fucking up, and the other Volkswagen vans haven't caught up to this shitty Volkswagen van yet.
Watch that final turn. It's pretty sharp. Use your brakes.
Nah. I'll just smash through this wall here. It'll be fine.
That's the finish line right there. Come on, all out.
I don't know. They just might catch up. Actually, that one is catching up. Yay! I got mail! See, at least that guy's stupid dance within the context of this actually makes sense. Alright, come on. All right.
No time to rest on your laurels. Keep going, driver.
What do you mean, rest on my laurels? What?
You have something in mind?
Anywho.
The next stop is all the way north.
So, yeah.
The Vintage Team has yet another road trip prepared for you. You'll have to reach an unknown location using the instructions you've been given. Just like you did before.
Just like you did before, you stupid bastard.
That's just another perfect opportunity for you to discover the island at your own pace and enjoy that 60s vibe support.
Oh, fuck.
I can tell you. This isn't about the destination, it's all about the journey.
Alright.
Icing on the cake, your ride will be the eternal 1969 Mustang Boss 429.
Alright. At least they're referencing one Mustang song. Mustang silly now, baby. Just a bit of snow. Mustang down. Dyke and the Breezers. Alright. Hey, look at that. It's right there. Hold
the tonkin. We're in for another nice and sweet ride. Keep an eye on your instructions, and you should reach that secret destination in no time.
Alright. Oh my god, it's a giant rock!
You got it. Stay on the right.
I mean, nothing can really compare to that giant rock. That was one giant fucking rock. Oh, there we go. Well, I gotta take a right up to that sign, huh? Oh. Went too far. Oh, Jesus. They're just gonna drop me before the... Alright. Can't make it too easy, I guess. Be a motherfucker.
You should see a church soon. Take a left right in front of it.
I take a left into it? God damn it! Alright, so this bus is broken down for some weird fucking reason. It's been there for so long that a historical reference has put it there. It says I'm supposed to turn, but there's nowhere to turn. There we go.
There is the finish line. Gun it.
Bang. Oh, I didn't mess that car up at all. I swear, it looked like that when I started.
Well done. Let's move on to the following event.
Alright, get to do some rallying.
I'll let you picture what's waiting for you next. Dirt roads, sunflower fields, and time attack. That's right, you're rallying in the 70s. Challenge, Kai has brought you a 1970 Japanese beauty, the Nissan Fairlady
Z432. Like you call the Nissan for and the Fairlady, but you call it a Z32. What? You won't call it a Z?
I have no idea what I just said.
How can I tell if someone driving around my house? Well, my windows are covered. Oh boy, someone is playing some music really fucking loud out there. Fortunately, my mic does not pick it up. Alright, let's roll, motherfucker.
Okay, so this is a rally, right? So I'm the co-pilot. Pay attention.
Alright.
Light curve on the right.
Oops.
Left curve.
Oh boy.
Do you use that traction control edition yet?
I'm not.
Right turn.
The grass is not being killed. Oh god, I'm starting to make no sense. Alright, I'm gonna hit the hay after this race. Well, I guess we'll check the fucking clothing to see if I got that wicked cool fucking denim vest, bro.
Long left, then long right.
Yeah. Getting scared, starting to pull some pussy shit.
Left turn, then right. Water, go for it. Full speed.
All right.
Get ready for another sharp left, then right.
All right. Honestly, I have no idea what the stream looks like right now. Alright. See, I'm actually starting to zone out here.
Shop right.
Thank you. Dakota. Trying to keep face on the road, man.
Right again, then left. Don't miss the bridge.
What bridge? Oh, fuck. Time!
Watch where you're going.
I'm trying. Make it. No. God damn it. Alright, we'll try one more time. I kept falling asleep here. Alright, one more time, and then I'm going to call it a night. Three, two, one, and kaboom. Let's roll, motherfuckers. All right.
Light curve on the right.
Slight curve on the right. Right.
Watch that left curve.
All right. So far, so good. Sure.
Right turn.
Oh, boy.
There's going to be a long left, then long right.
Fuck! Fuck, 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 fuck. God damn it, I can't keep this car on the road. I mean, it's cool, but, you know? Myself? Yes.
Right again, then left. Don't miss the bridge.
All right. There we go. Hell yeah. Alright. I'm going to call it a night, guys. I'm going to check for that jacket and see if I can find out how it looks on this character here. Alright.
driver. New challenges lie ahead.
Alright, so let's... Driver. Avatar customization. Clothes. Oh, damn it. I didn't know it would have the big fucking... what the hell? Let's see how it looks on her. Yeah, fuck it. It'll... Oh, wait a minute. Huh. I did beat it. Why do I not fucking... Hold on. Do I have to go to the main thing to get the... To get rewards? Let me try one thing and then I'm gonna call it a night, because I'm a little confuzzled here. As soon as I can find it. So how far away is it saying I am from this? All right. I'm going to call it a night. I ain't got the energy for this. Thank you all for joining my stream. Have a good night. I'll catch you guys all on the flip side, and Donut is going to go unconscious. Good night.